Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. Today we are going to create this simple ice cube tray in Autodesk Fusion 360, and then later we will create a drawing for this also. So I hope you like it. So let's start to create this simple tutorial for Fusion 360. Now let's start to make an ice cube tray in Autodesk Fusion 360. So we will start with new sketch. So simply select sketch. Now it will ask you which plane do you like to use. So we will use XY plane. That's it. Now just drop down this menu, create, and here we will start our main sketch. So we will select rectangle, center rectangle. Now see, first dimension we will put 105, press tab key. Then the second one is 285, tap enter. That's it. Now simply select finish sketch, and now here you can select extrude. We want to extrude how long we like to extrude. Now here we already selected this box profile, and we want to select in one side. So see here, dimension in one side, and this is distance, and here this is new body because there is no previous body. So the dimension we will use here 60 millimeter. Now see, okay, that's it. Even though right click, appearance, we will change the material. So here select component bodies. Now just drop, come down and choose here plastic. In plastic we will see opaque, glossy plastic. Okay, close. Select the top face, create sketch. From here toolbar you can select view, select this face, and it will ask you what kind of things you are going to perform. So same thing we will do it here, rectangle, circle, 2-point rectangle. Now the length we will define is 45 millimeter, press tab, 30 millimeter, tab enter. That's it. Now let me choose here dimension. So for dimension, either you can directly press D, or you have option here, sketch dimension. Distance from outer edge 5 millimeter, enter. Distance from this vertical horizontal outer 5 millimeter, enter. Now see, this is fully defined. Section view, finish sketch, and go to extruded boss, extrude. Now this time we want to cut. So first in profile it will ask you what do you like to use. First we will select. Now see, this is going upward direction. You will see the one direction distance, and here we will put distance 35, but this is going down upward, so simply put minus 35, so it will goes down. Now angle 10 degree, but this is outer one, so again here also we will put minus 30, and here option keep cut. If you take down it will automatically use, or otherwise you have to choose here. If you don't want to pick 35 10, and simply select cut, but see it's not going to choose, so you have to define minus 35 minus 10. Okay, that's it. Now let me select fillet, select face here, keep 2 millimeter. Again select new, select this face and here define 2 millimeter. Again choose new, select this face, 2 millimeter, new, this face, 2 millimeter. Again click on the plus sign, this face, 2 millimeter, enter. Now see, 2 millimeter corner radius is created. Now we need to make multiple number of patterns. Drop down, create, go to rectangular pattern. Now here first you have to define which things you are going to pattern. So we will choose feature. If you select feature from toolbar, you have to select two things, fillet, extrude. Now see, this is selected. Now select direction. Now here you will see the preview. So we will select this direction. Now it is going to ask you how many a distance. Arrow goes opposite side, so put minus 35 and here put 8 numbers. Now okay, we forget to change here. We will change spacing. We will keep spacing. Extent means you have to put whole dimension from one end to other end, but here we will choose spacing. Now this is minus 35. Now see, this comes in perfect position because the center gap is 5 millimeter, the width of box is 30 millimeter. So this is 30 millimeter, 8 number of things we like to make. And in direction 2, click 2 and distance. Here also we put distance minus 50. Now see, because the length is 45 millimeter for this box and 5 millimeter distance as gap. Now everything fine. Okay, now let's see the preview. Now look, even though you can hide from origin, click on this eye and the origin will hide. Now the next operation is shell. We have to select all the faces. And the thickness, 1 millimeter. Now see preview. Okay. Now let me choose fillet, one, I'll select all four corners, two, and put 5 millimeter, enter. Now see, all four corners trimmed 5 millimeter or become 5 millimeter radius. Now for eyes tray we will add one support here, so we will choose any mid plane. Just drop, open and let's see which plane is suitable. XZ plane, this is perfect. XZ plane, sketch. Now let me choose here line command, and we will try from this side, better option. Now here simply press 5, enter, then again move in one direction, press 3, click, then in upward direction put 1, click. Now here press 2, click, and go upward side. Now see, this is closed geometry. Finish sketch. Now it's time to create. Use swept command. Sweep. First you have to choose here, this is single path, and select profile. So let me choose this L-shaped profile. Now select path. So I'll choose this path. Now see, automatically it took this shape. You can see the preview. Distance is 1 mm, and this is joint option. We don't need to cut. Okay, that's it. Right click, appearance, the same, remove and keep. See, close. Now you can simply hide axis. So this is the simple way to create a tray in Autodesk Fusion 360. Further also we will do many examples. So let's start to create. Let me save first. Ice cube tray 1. Save. Now we want to make drawing. So what we will do, just simply select new drawing from design, or even though you can choose option from here, drop down the menu of designs, drawing from design. Now it will ask you this thing. So first option is fully assembly. This is single part, so no, it is doesn't matter click or if you not click. We want to create a new drawing from scratch, and from here we will select any standard. So let's keep ISO standard. Units either inches or millimeter, so I'll keep millimeter. And here sheet size A3 size 420 by 297. Okay, now once you select okay, it will give forward you in drawing. See, now you will see here top view, see front view, and dimensions we will change from here 2.5, or if you don't like, better to keep 2. Now simply select here place and okay. Now here you will see one option, projected view, click and drag. 1, 2, enter 2 out. Now select this, click on the center part and move wherever you want to keep. So we will keep here, double click, and you will see one option from here. You can change the style like shaded, close. See, now let me choose here dimension, and I'll start to define this one from one end to other end, 285. This is the separately we created 4 millimeter 3 millimeter, 1 millimeter. Five millimeter. And the distance from here to the bottom is 36 millimeter because 1 millimeter thickness and depth is 35 millimeter. And corner radius. So this is on what, this is the way you can assign the dimensions. See, outer dimension 111 by 291, because we added 3 millimeter in both side. If you want to make section view for this, simply select detailed view, select this view, click anywhere and draw and simply put here visible hidden edges. Okay, now see, even though you can define separately the dimensions, see, this is so simple. So this is how we created a simple ice cube tray in Autodesk Fusion 360, and we made a simple drawing. I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video, and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. If you like to save this one, click save. Actually, you must need a good internet connection. Now see here, the name of this project is ice cube tray drawing. We already saved as a tray, but now it's added drawing. Save. Now it will save in server. Thanks for watching.